Hiram, I know you've been waiting, so we're back with the assistant league president and the former president, Monica and Kim. We're also here with Steve Ochoa, who is the founder of the nonprofit GIFT, and of course, my beautiful wife, Sandra. So don't worry about me. She's going to be doing all the talking for the rest of the show.
Yeah, nice way to jump out there. So with the assistance league, how many schools are you working with?
We're working with 39 schools. There's a couple of agencies as well, but just round it to 40.
Okay. And what grades is that?
It's pre-kindergarten, depending on the elementary school, up to 8th grade.
Do you find that, I know you talked about providing hoodies, does each school have different dress code requirements, like no names on the hoodies and things like that, or do you guys kind of stay within those lanes pretty tightly so that nobody gets in trouble at school?
Yeah, the hoodies are not, they're black and gray, you know, they're not colors. And for the uniforms, they're different colors, so each school has like light blue, white, so we have to stock for the different schools.
And that you guys are warehousing then quite a large, I would imagine, quite a large variety of clothing.
Yes. It's when you drive down 1307 Alvernon, there's two buildings. One is kind of where our thrift shop is, and the other is the philanthropic building, and half of it is a warehouse.
And we were very fortunate in the early 2000s to be able to build the philanthropic building through generous donations, grants, and a big capital campaign, because it has a warehouse on the back of it where we can actually order in bulk for less, better quality, less price, so we can dress more kids.
Exactly.
That's awesome. The thrift store you mentioned, do you want to talk a little bit about how that funds you and what percentage of your funding comes from a thrift store?
Oh, absolutely. This is one of our best parts. So more than 50% of our funding comes from our thrift shop. So when you clean out your closets, think of us, please. We love donations. We are located at 1307 North Alvernon, one block north of Speedway. You can drop off donations during our thrift shop hours anytime, Monday through Saturday now, 10 to 2, drop off your donations. Also, if you happen to be a business with excess inventory, we would be happy to work with you and figure out how to accept that donation as well. Leftovers from a community yard sale or an event are always welcome too. Mm-hmm. So, and then the rest of our funding comes from grants and donations from people who are listening to this program.
How do they reach you on the web? What's your website?
Our website is altucson.org.
Again, so everybody can hear it.
altucson.org.
Now, I'm guessing that with the thrift store and with the involvement with the schools, that you guys probably have a pretty large volunteer base that you pull from.
We do. It's over 300.
Whoa.
And what's kind of neat is 100 of them, well, 111 exactly, are assistants. So these are high school kids that volunteer, and they work in our thrift shop. They work at Operation School Bell. They also work within the community. So, a third of our volunteers are teenagers.
And they volunteer with us from 9th grade to 12th grade. So they also have the opportunity to volunteer at other nonprofits around town to see what it means to give back to your community. And they also give grants to middle schools.
The one question we didn't ask is, what grades do you guys support?
Pre-kindergarten to 8th grade.
Okay, so everybody has to do pre...
We have a different program that Kim mentioned where our assistants actually get applications from different middle schools where a teacher will say, I need new band equipment, I need this, and their fundraising pays for this. Can I tell you the best thing that happened last?
Yes.
So what they did is a school said, we want to send our students up to the MIM Museum, the Music Instrument Museum. So the award that we gave them was they got a bus, they got to drive up to go to the museum, and it was the music class. So if you've ever, I'm sounding like a commercial for MIM, but it's an amazing museum where it's music from around the world.
Right.
So some of these kids have never been on a bus, never gone up to Scottsdale. So
it's not only clothes, it's experiences you guys are providing to the community. So it's not this one thing, we're not just doing one thing. We're doing whatever we can to warm those kids' hearts as they as they go through school with all the difficulties they're having at this time?
Well, you know, like middle schools and all schools are always underfunded in the arts and PE and that sort of thing, and music. So, I mean, one year we funded violin strings for an entire orchestra because they had violins, but they didn't have strings. So they were playing when they were done. So it was great.
Mariachi. Mariachi equipment.
I mean, just fun stuff.
Yeah.
How involved are the high school volunteers in that application process or vetting the requests that come through?
100%.
Wow.
They could go through it and say, you know, they didn't fill out the application right. I'm not picking them. So they raise the funds and they're giving the funds.
They have ownership.
Yes.
One thing I thought would be good to ask, though, you guys are doing this, you guys are smiling all the way through. I'm sure you're smiling, Kim, all the way through this. The question is that, why do you feel this program is so important to the community?
Dignity. I mean, we want these kids to start off, when you're talking about Operation School Bell, we want them to, if you're in school, then you're going to learn about things. Mm-hmm. If you think school's not cool or you don't need to go to school or whatever, that doesn't help.
Right, right. Want to add anything, Kim?
I was just going to say, I remember at one of our dressings, there was a young boy who seemed to love school, just loved it. But he was absent at least one day a week, according to the school rep who was there with them. And when he was asked why he didn't come to school yesterday, he said, "My mom and I share one pair of shoes. If she gets work, she has to wear the shoes, and I have to stay home from school." So just imagine the potential of a child who gets to attend school every day. And so I'm proud to announce that that child did receive a brand new pair of shoes of his very own.
It's the little things like that, the little stories, you know, that helps you understand why that's important. It's mm-hmm. important for people who are underserved and people who listen to the radio show. If you got a chance and you're worrying about whether your kids don't have enough, give you guys a call or go by 1307 North Alvin Island Way or go to altucson.org and give you guys an email, let you know what's going on. Maybe you can help them. And do they have to, everyone has to go through a school?
Yeah.
Okay, that's important, okay.
So it's part of our, and look, we would love to have every school involved with this, but you know, it boils down to funding.
Right.
But the schools that we do have, what happens is, so how we fulfill this is, there is at each school, there is a school rep, and they get a voucher, and then they take the voucher to either Target, to our Target dressings,
wow.
or to our facility.
Yeah.
So, do you have anything new that's happening this year?
We do. We're starting a new program, and it's Adopt a School program. And we're hoping that we can work with a lovely school that's called a community school, like the Achoya Community School. but, you know, and because we want to grow and have more schools involved, but we just don't want to do what we would call a, you know, one time and then next year, sorry, we can't have you in our program.
Right, right.
So how does someone, what's the process if somebody wanted to adopt a school?
Well, it would be, yes. I mean, it costs $100 per child to dress a child. So you could just do the math. And so, it would just say, hey, this is what we want to do, and then we'd work with you to make it happen. I mean, but
you could say, I want to dress 20 children at this school because
oh, okay.
I went here. I graduated from here. It means a lot to me or my family name. You know, my family has been associated with school. I have a teachers I want to honor. Or you could say, I want to dress 10 children every year. And so you just give Assistance League a call, and we will absolutely work with you to make happen however you want it to work.
So I'll just put a challenge out there to businesses that aren't involved in the community, that this would be a great way to get your employees involved and to have something that kind of brings everyone together. And with that said, I think before we go, because we're running out of time here, we want to hear a little bit about a celebration that's going on at the Ochoa School coming up.
So, Steve?
Well, thanks, guys. It's me back. And I'm happy to tell all of you that Ochoa is going to celebrate its 100th year here in Tucson. It was founded, they tell me, and according to their records, in about 1923 or so. But anyways, the good news is there's going to be a wonderful fiesta happening on May 12th from 5 to 7 at the school, which is basically 6th Avenue and 25th Avenue. And it's going to be so great because they've got mariachis. They've got a DJ. They've got a jumping castle. They've got a train and plenty for me. Wow. Food trucks. So that's coming up. And the great thing about Ochoa, there's many, but the community really rallies around this wonderful school. And I see generational parents attending meetings. And the fiesta, we're going to have a community. We think it's going to be huge. And we'd like to encourage all our viewers to come on down, check out Ochoa, get some chime with some great, great people, and recognize this great community school, Ochoa Community.
We'd like to thank Kim Sparling, who's the Vice President of Resource Development and former President of the Assisting League of Tucson. And we also like to thank Monica Stavot, the President of the Assisting League of Tucson. And one more for Steve Ochoa, who is the founder of the nonprofit.
And also, we just wanted to remind you that if you have any real estate needs, Raymond, Danielle, and I are happy to help you. You can email us at johnsonsmith@indie, that's INDIE-realty.com. We also have sponsors that make this programming possible: Indie Realty, Inspired Life Mortgage, Rego Pest Prevention, Pioneer Title Agency, and Caring Transitions. You know, we couldn't do this without them. So if you do reach out to one of our sponsors, please let them know that you heard about them on the I Am Real Estate show on KVOI.
We'd like to thank Kim, Monica, and Steve for joining us on the show. And this show, second portion, we're always talking about the Assisting League of Tucson at altucson.org. Look them up. See you soon.